the first quarter, we had about 0.4%. In the second quarter, we had about 2.05% negative growth rate. And then in the third quarter, we also had about around 2.6% minor negative growth rate. I think this is due to a combination of several factors. First was the delay in the budget, first of all, submission of the budget, and then delay in the release of funding for critical sectors of the economy. And of course, the issue of the exchange rate affects the affects various sectors of the economy, especially manufacturing. But we can also cannot and should not ignore the what happened with the price of oil, and also what happened with oil production with the Niger Delta Avengers. I think all of this reduced revenue considerably for both the federal government and the state government. And as a result, this percolates also into a different component of the GDP, including reduction in per capita consumption, reduction in investment, both in the private sector as well as in the public sector, due to lack of confidence from the private sector people. Especially in the third quarter, I think most people were not expecting that the GDP growth rate will be that bad. However, when you also compare it with other countries, I think we've had a massive oil price shock, which also affected not only Nigeria, but also other economies. One of the things that I found out from the work that I've done is that those countries that had oil savings were able to essentially move forward with, were able to withstand the economic shock better than those who did not. First, per capita income has fallen. Inflation has gone up to about 18% from around 9% in 2015. It has doubled, essentially. Unemployment has also gone up. And with the unemployment going up, interest rate has also crept up. As a result, the mystery index, what we call the mystery index, which will be the combination of inflation rate, unemployment, high lending rate, and negative GDP growth rate, has also increased. And I think on the mystery indices, Nigeria is probably among the between the number one and number six globally. So the mystery indices are, mystery index has essentially gone up, and this measures what happened with inflation rate. And when you say 18% increase in inflation rate, doubling, the inflation rate doubling, when you look actually at some products, individual products, some of them, their prices have gone up more than being doubled. So in terms of consumer spending, their purchasing power has been eroded with inflation going up. For those who do not have employment or who lost their job, you also have a shock in terms of reduced income. Besides the fact that they can no longer purchase what they were purchasing 1 year ago at the same price, some have also lost their job and therefore lost their income. In terms of businesses, what you see, if you look at the annual report or even quarterly report of some of the manufacturing industries, they are also feeling the impact of this as their profit is going down, because their revenue is not matching up with maybe their estimation. Their costs are also going up because they have to import raw materials and so on and so forth. So from the consumption sector, from a perspective, from the household perspective, from the business perspective, you have a situation whereby the economy, what is happening at the macroeconomy, is percolating to the microeconomy. And then when you look at the financial sector, You see a situation of rising NPL, non-performing loans, and so on. And some banks, when you look at their stock prices, this is reflecting the fact that they are also suffering in a way from what is happening to the economy, from what is happening with the exchange rate pressure, and so on and so forth. So, in terms of consumption, in terms of businesses, in terms of household, in terms of government, we've seen the severe impact on the economy. I think 2017, we should see positive growth rate overall. The first half will continue to be difficult. I know the multilateral institution, including the IMF, I'm looking forward to seeing what their projection for Nigeria will be for 2017, because they keep revising this thing. But if you look at the beyond the GDP, let's also hope that inflation rate will bottom up or bottom out at around, say, 20% by 2016, so that from 2017, it should start coming down. You know, I think if the exchange rate issue is effectively handled, we might see more portfolio flows coming in. But overall, I think there are so many other things that needs to be done beyond exchange rate, beyond fiscal policy, beyond monetary policy. You also have structural issues and institutional issues that needs to be handled. Property rights, cost of doing business, our ranking on cost of doing business, and then our ranking of on global competitiveness report needs to move up. And if we take measures that will address some of these constraints, I think this will build confidence and trust among the private sector, among international investors and domestic investors. And I think with this, the economy in 2017, you can say, should be and will be better than in 2016.